Taylor and Councilman Davis had talked to the merchants on hiring the city's downtown coordinator that quit approximately about a month ago. And we discussed with the merchants about them planning the events downtown instead of us hiring something. And the merchants are in agreement. The merchants are in agreement. The few that had set up for the meetings are in agreement. They drafted some bylaws. And we're waiting on a decision from council on if they want to go with the merchants planning the events.
And just to add as well, as has been discussed and pointed out by the city attorney, and you may want to elaborate, basically what this would entail is the downtown business owners would come to the city council, so that would not be a removed step in the process, just as our former downtown development coordinators have come to the council for requests for expenditures. In this case, is if it rises above the threshold, of course, downtown business owners for their specific events would ideally present a budget that would include estimations of cost for what a particular event would run, and they would be able to present to the council, entertain any questions, and then they would then take those specific requests for expenditures to staff. And we would cut the check to the appropriate vendors to provide for events that, of course, are in the best interest of the citizens in the list that have always been provided. You know, and those events would include but not be limited to the Christmas parade and festival, the fall festival, the Christmas tree lighting, the National Night Out, which is sort of a joint effort from staff as well as involvement of business owners in the form of donations. The Easter egg hunt, which has also been known as the egg run, and other events. So there's a lot of opportunity there for the business owners to sort of jump in and to have an opportunity to have direct control over these events, and they, of course, would benefit all citizens as well.
They will come before the council and give a budget of a event before anything is beyond the threshold.
Well, I think what we were saying was if they come to the council with a budget more than $1,000. But if it was less than $1,000, they would pass it.
Plan each event. They do nice three or four of them together now, and the council authorizes the spending for them. But see, you got up to $1,000, you spend taxpayer money without approval of the taxpayer. I don't think that's really the right way to go through. So,
well, that was the same thing we were doing while we had the coordinator. She was spending the money without coming to council unless it was a big event, like the one that she had Snow Day, which was a very big event. She did come to council on that, but anything small, she did not come to the council.
Well, she was a city employee, spent the same money. That was talking about.
Well, they can't spend the money unless I approve it or the John can approve it.
Like billboards, there's been discussion since the billboard contract was concluded that there was a desire for some fresh air breathed into that effort with a new design on a billboard, and a consensus among the business owners, at least from what I understand, that they want the billboard to come back. So obviously, if they were able to solicit various proposals and quotes or to guide a vendor in mind with a proposal, they would come before the council and talk to you all about it. It would be an annual contract, but the council would have to vote on it for that provision, and would be consistent with the money that's allocated within downtown development budget.
Rob, is you in agreement that Mayor and City Manager should spend $1,000 for private businesses without bringing to council the budget title?
Let me just clarify that, just one sentence you made there, Ralph. You're not authorizing the mayor or the city manager to spend up to $1,000 for a private business. This is a merchants association that has formed, and they're putting on an event for the city of Payhawa. We are not spending citizens' money for a private merchant.
Well, the merchants organization is still a private organization.
But they're putting on the events for the city of Payhawa.
Well, then you said they're going to put together the budget plan. I think they should have that prior to doing anything. They should present that.
Anything you do, you have to have a budget and a plan.
And they'll present that to the council.
You have to serve $1,000.
How is this process handled financially and otherwise, and the relationship between the city and the downtown merchants different as it is proposed tonight than it was when Brandy was working for the city?
She was a city employee with that?
To me it is no different other than we do not have to pay an employee.
Right, there's quite a bit within the budget that was allocated there for staff. And obviously, if council so chose, the staffing portion of the budget could actually be placed in events. So you've got potentially a lot of funds that's there that could be spent directly on events that would benefit citizens. And of course, when we talk about events that benefit citizens, I just gave a brief list there. But there's certainly creativity that's not just restricted to one, but many. If you've got a room full of individuals that are sitting around a table talking about events that benefit the city of Payhawa, I think you've got an opportunity there for a lot of creativity. And if they know that they have resources, yes, they do have to ask for permission to those resources, but they've got a means actually to see their dreams come true. And if if somebody is in a position to be able to accomplish their vision with what they see and they're given the tools to do that, then I think that's the proposal that's before you. You've got a group of individuals that have formed an association that are looking for assistance to provide for events that benefit everyone, not just businesses, but men, women, and children, private citizens as well.
So basically, the long and short of it, you have a group of individuals that are willing to donate any kind of services to the city. That's ultimately.
We were providing staff to do it.
Right.
We had a staff member come in on a part-time basis with an allocated amount of $15,000. So basically, what we have is a group of an actual group of business owners that have formed an association or are in the process of doing that. That will step in to fill that gap.
That's right.
So the only difference, and correct me if I'm wrong, the only difference between when a downtown coordinator was handling these processes and responsibilities and the proposal that's before the city council tonight is that the downtown coordinator handled the payments and some coordination with the merchants. Now that responsibility will paying bills and dealing with the downtown merchants will be handled primarily through City Hall, namely the city manager and the mayor. I see that as the only difference here. Am I incorrect? So this is in short, that means this is a program that's been going on how long? The downtown coordinator program has been, I don't know how many there have been, how long has it been going on?
10, 12, 15 years. That hometown program started in the mid to late 90s. So
nearly 20 years, this same process has been taking place. The only difference is that now the city manager and the mayor will be overseeing the payments of what's been going on, what's going to be spent.
Sure.
Up to $1,000, and if there's $1,000 or higher request, then the merchants will bring that request to you. We are south of the net line. The only difference is that $1,000 or greater request will require the downtown merchants to come and have a detailed request in front of the council. Is that correct?
Correct.
Okay.
Basically, what the go back a number of years, we call it now downtown authority, but it was a person hired to put on activities the citizens may hire. Recently, there was a lot of friction developed between the businesses and persons in that position. The person that had that position basically looking out for the taxpayer, putting on events for the people of the city, not bring business in. There was a lot of friction because she put activities on at night when the business were closed, etc. I've heard the whole story. So, I think spending taxpayers' money, if we want to spend taxpayer money for events, it should be for city events that the citizens pay out when businesses are part of the city. But originally, that program was set up for special events for the citizens of the city to pay taxes, and that's what they expect. They don't expect us to go off and hand money out to businesses without prior authorization of the council.
Ralph, I can assure you that, sitting in on the meetings and listening to what they've had to say, they have a great understanding, and they've stated that they're going to be responsible for some events that won't help them at all. They've made that statement several times, that they understand that there's a need to have events. They're not going to bring any business in there, anybody into their business. They understand that. But in spite of that, they're willing to take this on and to work.
Well,
and there is no agenda for them to do something just for themselves.
I'm not the only point I'm arguing is I want the city, the taxpayer, to know what's going to be spent for these activities. And that's what we did when we had branding. It was published out every month.
There is no reason why that should change and be any different than what we have done in the past. The same process. Everyone will be informed just like they were in the past. It'll be a part of the budget. The expenditures will be recorded in our budget. It'll be under $1,000. It'll be recorded. It'll be public information that people can see and question. They'll come for us with anything over $1,000. And so,
what is the problem having them come and present a budget to the council and say, hey, this is what we expect to spend for this activity? What is the problem with that?
Absolutely nothing.
Then why can't we do it that way?
Well, because that's not the way we've done it in the past, and it has been a very good system of taking care of the
people. We are talking an employee of the city versus private businesses.
It's the same thing. We got the same thing, Ralph.
No, okay.
Same thing.
I made my point.
We've got an employee of the city, our city manager, who's just stepping in and doing double duty.
Okay.
And he's willing to take that on.
Okay.
I'll take one.
That a boy.
All right, so any more comments?
What exactly is the proposal that's before the council? This is the question.
The proposal will be many new merchants association, the group that's gotten together, put on the events for the city, and still use their budget that the city does every, the city has a budget every year.
Problem we have events. Would it be necessary for us to do that? In essence, we're not changing anything. And since the conversation earlier was that, since this is an entity outside, why would that have to be?
Well, we are changing one thing. The salary that was budgeted for the downtown coordinator is being offered to increase the merchant's budget.
Well, if anything, I would think that the simplest thing we would need to do then would be just to approve that that portion of the budget be moved to put into the overall budget for use in city events, period.
My concern is that there's talk of the formation of a Tejar Merchants Association, which is great. They should do that if they want to do that. But it's not clear to me whether you all are talking about kind of making that some pseudo-government or city government agency or recognizing that.
Thus, I think
this is just them more or less the merchants trying to get together.
Right.
And organize themselves to have a better downtown district heritage.
There's been many informal arrangements of business owners groups over the years. This is actually the most formal effort that has been undertaken in about 10 years for that. So basically they're going to have a president, they're going to have a treasurer, a vice president, group there of individuals that are going to be committed to putting on these events. But the same stop or the same safeguards that are in place on public funds will always still exist. You'll just have a different group, in essence, coming to the council or coming to the staff to make a request for those funds.
So essentially it's just a variation on what has been going on for years with the Honeybee Festival.
Okay.
There's a Honeybee committee that runs this festival. They come to the city and ask for whatever assistance they need from the city.
Right.
They don't ask for money. They never ask for money.
So we provide thousands of dollars in services
for them, our traffic control, and that sort of thing.
It's the most expensive event we put on every year. And I will say we put on, the Honeybee Festival Committee coordinates it, but police, staff time, fire, public works, it's a significant cost.
Right. I think
there would not be any cash to the hands of any merchants.
Thus, I think I don't think we should be making a motion regarding the organization. We should be making a motion regarding the monies that are available within our budget and how those will be designated, not just for them,
but for events. I guess that's what needs to be real clear. There's an agenda item, but I'm not really clear what's being put up.
Right,
vote right on it. You all need to spell that.
We need something right to explain how this is going to operate, what the budget's going to be, how it's going to be disseminated, how the cash is going to be disseminated.
Here's my suggestion. Y'all do it what you want. It appears that the idea is to take the money that had been allocated to salary and put into the downtown coordinator. Just move that into a separate budget item for tourism promotion, business development, whatever you all want to call it. And that way you do have a budgeted item that you can spend from.
But we're going to have to get some type of resolution or some type of document to justify spending this money to.
Or just a motion to amend the budget to create that budget. Now, right now, how that money is spent, that's
right.
That's up to y'all, but. You need to create a budget item, a budget line item that you need to spend.
Essentially what you're doing is you're amending the budget ahead of time. As we do, we amend the budget every year in December with any amendments that are required. Well, now you're just amending the budget in July for this one provision.
Is there a precedent to do that?
Not really, but there's nothing that says you can't do that.
Okay.
There's an understanding there that the money, instead of going to that salary line item, that we spend in promotion.
Right.
Okay, I want to go back and ask another question. Why are we not hiring somebody to do promotion for the city citizens? It's a citizens that hire them. Why are we hiring somebody to do that to replace Brandon?
Well, there were several meetings with the
downtown business owners, and I thought Councilman Barfield had a great suggestion, was to, when this came up where Brandy resigned, that question was raised whether we should continue that, given the success of that particular program in recent years. A number of reasons, one of which you mentioned yourself, was that there was some tension between people that were handling the program on both sides. So it was suggested that we ask, and I thought it was a good idea, that the downtown business owners be involved in what their thoughts were. And they thought, ultimately, that it would be a good idea to, they suggested that the city not replace the downtown coordinator for the same reasons. And it was also suggested to them that would they be interested in continuing a downtown merchants program on their own with the benefit of the budget that they had before plus the salary that the downtown coordinator had before. That's why they helped make that decision.
Well, you just hit that nail on the head. They didn't want, businesses didn't want somebody to run the events for the citizens of the area. They want somebody to run events for the businesses.
No, they don't.
No,
well, why are we hiring a new coordinator to handle events for the citizens they hire?
I'll be very honest with you, Ralph. I think it's a more prudent expenditure of our resources to, if we have limited resources to put into events, and to put into promoting this situation, and we have capable people in this town. Some of these business owners are very bright, creative, capable, hardworking people who have been citizens of this town for years, grew up in this town, love this town. They don't have an agenda just for themselves. That's the one thing that I've heard over and over. This is not an agenda to promote just themselves. It's an agenda to promote the city. They love this city. That's why they're doing business here, because they love the city.
Okay.
If they didn't, they would be moved. So,
they would like
simply to say, why would we go out and hire someone to do that when they can take their ideas, who would be just as bright and just as capable, and to promote the city and take and save that dollar and utilize that dollar in a better way, which is to actually put into the operation of these events and enhance those events. Make them even better. And
right.
It makes perfect sense.
Let's look at some other things. Every event just about has been free. Like Brandy and her presence, selling merchandise,